It won't be long now.
At least she's comfortable.
There's definitely worse ways to go.
Amen.
Oh, and she's gone.
Oh, good for her. Just hope someone interesting moves in, you know? Like a ball player or an astronaut. Right, well, tomorrow, of course, is Food Club, when Thor will be explaining the subtle differences between types of cod.
It will be similar to salmon lecture, but more cod-focused.
Ooh. It's actually delightful.
Oh.
Yeah, it's really? Divine.
Oh, let me hit that.
I would enjoy if I
was that the sage or is okay. That her?
Reminds me of Torch Village.
Okay, people, there's enough spirit repellent for all of us.
No!
I hate getting walked through. It's probably the worst pain I can think of. No, wait, arrow through the neck. That beats it.
Okay, new plan. Kill them!
We can't kill them.
Yeah, that's not nice.
Well, I was thinking, since Alberta was a singer in life and can project her humming into the world of the living, what if we had her hum the song from the movie Ghost to scare them? Huh? Kind of thematic, right?
You know we don't know what that is, Pete.
Oh, right, the movie thing. Good luck, everybody! And have fun! Haunting is hard. Ooh, that is rank. Shut up. All right. Trevor. What are you doing? The livings aren't even here.
No, I know. This isn't for them. This is between Team Money and the Vaz. It's personal.
I've always said vase.
Can you?
Sorry.
Please. Okay, a little too close.
Sure. Okay.
Oh, that was good. I was going to be it.
I felt that was going to be it. I felt that.
Really? That was so close.
So it's amazing. You're incredible.
Watch out!
Carol and I argued the last time we spoke. It's funny, it felt like such a big deal at the time, and now I can't even tell you what it was we were arguing about. You never think when you close that door behind you that that'll be the last time you walk through that door. But then I had my accident and I realized I'm never gonna see my wife again. I'm never gonna get to speak to her, to hold her, to tell her how much I love her.
Jerry and I were having an affair while Pete was still alive.
Oh, good God.
Oh, wait. I remember what we were fighting about. She ate all the donut holes. And she doesn't even like donut holes. It was just to spite me, which was just like her. Selfish so-and-so.
Pete. The point is, life is precious.
What is donut hole?
It's just a round donut. It's what's missing. It doesn't matter.
Thank you, Alberta. I don't know how many times we've heard that song.
487.
But it gets better every time. Okay, yes, the hotel will be a nightmare, but gosh darn it, I did miss those crazy kids. Hello? Well, yep. She can still see us.
Ooh. Yes!
Also, she's apparently a little cranky before she's had her coffee. My doc was pretty worried about my blood pressure. Luckily, didn't turn out to be a problem.
Oh, what happened?
There's an air. We've been through this.
Then we drive them from this land!
Yes! Or have a nice, friendly chat! Hi there. Hello? All right, I know you're actively ignoring us, but that's okay. I was married for 16 years, so I get it. Oh, you looked at me. She looked at me. Oh, it's working. Hello. Oh, okay. Well, I'm down for a stroll. Where are we headed? On behalf of my fellow ghosts, I'd just like to welcome you
two. You're not real.
I mean, I'm not technically alive, but I am real.
No, you're not.
You're answering me.
No, I'm not. Oh.
Because I love you.
Aw, he's a keeper.
Hold that thought.
What was that? Sam!
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 Okay, so that is everybody. Oh, what about you?
I just wanted to say hi and welcome.
Hi.
Welcome! These new glosses are fantastic, but yeah, fight's probably more interesting.
So, back to the pain.
Ooh, I wonder if it dried lighter. Oh. Sam! Quick favor, could you look up all the Met scores for me for the last 37 years?
Something with the fountain I need to show you and Jay.
Probably should have done the roof.
Shut up, Pete!
My name is Mark.
Yeah, of course it is. Bye, Pete. Boop, boop.
Oh, you ate a floor Oreo?
Not cool, guys. Not cool.
I would have called it a Florio. That's just my improv training kicking in. Florio. I wish I possessed the ability to write that down.
I told her a nip of cocaine would wipe that hay fever right out, but does she listen?
I'm sorry, did you say cocaine?
Oh, Pete just came in.
The Arrow guy?
Or the award-winning travel agent, or the great dad? But sure, Arrow guy, let's go with that.
Yeah, there's a spider in the attic that's spinning some pretty interesting stuff. Oh, and I haven't tried to remember all the Star Trek characters' names in a bit. I mean, there's Spock, obviously. What do you think, Sam?
Which is often mispronounced as badminton.
Sam.
Silent N.
Oh, no, could she not hear us anymore? Hey, Sam?
No silent N.
Sam! Sam! Trevor, I did not understand that story or the points you were making, but I am so sorry.
Some of you stand around, keep a lookout, while I watch you talking with Trev.
Oh, you know what? I'll join you.
What? No, you guys are the worst army ever.
I never saw it. It came out the year before I died, but you know how it is between work and family and getting shot in the neck with an arrow.
What the H-E double hockey sticks is this movie?
Hey, man, I can't believe kids are capable of this sort of thing.
Didn't kids murder you?
Well, that was an accident. I'm pretty sure.
Are you slow clapping your own speech?
You're damn right I am. They haven't seen an 80s movie and you didn't start it, so I have to.
And just like everything else, when it comes to nature and safety, or even plain old life lessons, it's all in this book. Which brings us to today's lesson, archery! Now, I'm sure we all just want to start flinging arrows at the targets, but first, we need to go over some basic safety rules, okay? Rule number one, and I cannot emphasize this enough, never notch an arrow when someone is downrange. Is it in my neck? This is actually a great opportunity to discuss what to do in this situation, right? Becky, you want to run and tell the lady at the house, see if you can use her phone? I'm actually gonna take a nap behind the shed over there. Let's reconvene in 15, okay? 15, 20.
What's your wife's name?
Carol Martino. Now, it's been a while, so you may need to hire a PI, track down some leads. You're gonna wanna go to every JCPenney, IHOP, anywhere that sells beads.
Found her.
Excuse me? That's her.
Looks like your wife still lives nearby.
Oh my God. Carol, if you are listening, please visit Woodstone Mansion. Love, Pete.
Pete, this is incredible. Did you highlight all this stuff and write all these notes?
I was never without this book. Carol knows how important this was to me. She'll come get it if you tell her you found it.
Pete, I don't know.
Please. Carol's almost 70. I don't know if I'm going to get a chance to see her again. Hey, Carol, it's me. It's Pete, your Petey Pie, the repeater.
Can you not?
Okay.
Hear me, Carol, because I can hear you just fine.
This is bad. This is very bad.
Petey Pie! I just can't believe I'm about to see my wife after all these years.
Hey, who knows? Maybe she'll drop dead while she's here and become a ghost.
Carol, let go!
Do you think that's possible? She did suffer from hypertension, even in her 40s.
Why are you trying to get his hopes up?
Sorry.
No, you're right. You're right. I'm just gonna try to enjoy the day, even if my wife doesn't die.
The carriage approaches.
What? Oh! Carol! Oh my God, it's happening. My Care Bear.
What?
She brought Jerry. Jerry Bean! This is amazing.
Hello.
Jerry! Carol! They can't see me.
Remember, Pete and I had too many margaritas.
Yes.
And we drove a golf cart into the pond.
Hey, you got a side.
Something. Jerry and I were having an affair while Pete was still alive.
Oh, good God.
Truthfully, I think Pete knew.
I did not know. Well, here they come. Oh, yeah, find a spot for it. My so-called best friend and my so-called wife.
Mm. Well, I mean, she was literally his wife, any act of indiscretion notwithstanding.
Oh, is that so, Isaac?
I mean, grammatically, yes, but not hugely important right now.
Pete, you're taking this too hard. Jerry probably just offered something sexually that you couldn't, and that's a good thing. He took it off your plate.
Flower, if you weren't already dead, I would kill you.
Pete was one of a kind. He was the cornerstone of the family.
These words mean nothing.
So
you know what else meant nothing? Our wedding vows.
He was always there for everyone. You could always find Pete whenever you needed
there
him.
There I was, a chump at every turn. I guess You May Kiss the Bride was directed at everybody.
All right, we're late.
someone couldn't find their special socks. Could you, Pete?
Did you hear that? His name's Pete. I'm a grandpa.
Grandpa Pete.